Hello friends and colleagues.
Today I want to show you a practical guide for vetting, port state control and American Coast Guard inspection on deck. Always remember, first impression is also the last impression. Make sure that Gangway watch speaks good English and is nicely presented, wearing also orange security vest, and the watchman will introduce tanker safety measures briefly to all visitors. 3-4 sentences are enough. Take time to read the applicable safety measures on board at the Gangway notice regarding mobiles, naked lights, non-intrinsically equipment which are not allowed on open deck, and also smoking regulations on board. Visitor card and safety guidance sheet to be handed to visitor inspector. Don't forget to check the photo ID, even if it is IMO Secretary General coming on board. The visitor should be escorted to the master by a watch officer via the catwalk only. If you have multinational crew and mixed nationalities are on watch at the same time, make sure that communication is done in English. The inspector will normally start deck round with master and chief officer from Monkey Island and then lower down to the bridge wings. On the Monkey Island, he will check if all the aerials and connections are safe. He will check all the signal lights are in good condition and intact. He will check the main mast for possible damages or cracks. He will check magnetic compass for any bubbles in the liquid. He will check the VDR condition and the battery expiry date. He will try to open close mushroom ventilation flaps. He will check the light casings around the accommodation are intact and in good condition. He will check the condition of provision cranes, hook, rollers, wire condition, stencils of safe weight load, and date of annual inspection. The inspector will check maximum angle indicator of the crane derrick. Fire hose box with nozzle should be in good condition. Spanner inside fire box. The inspector will ask to start emergency fire pump and check the delivered pressure on the manometer. Then he will ask to open nozzles of two fire hoses, one prepared on the bridge wing and the other on the bow to see and check the actual water jet spray and test the condition of fire hoses for any leakages. He will check that man overboard marked expiry date of hydrostatic release unit and life buoy line is properly connected. Life buoy release mechanism should be in good condition. He will check general condition of the emergency position indicating radio beacon, its battery expiry date, hydrostatic release unit, and try to make operational test of the light. The inspector will also visit the battery room to check the condition of batteries for GMDSS and that personal protective equipment is in place. During his descent to the lower decks, he will check the conditions of the accommodation decks and also randomly check of the fire hose boxes. He can randomly check fire hydrants. The coupling should be in good condition. Rubber gasket, greased and attached cap should have special hole for the leakage monitoring. Ventilation around accommodation to be kept closed during cargo operations. The air conditioning unit must be kept on recirculation mode. Plugs of the air and water supply valves should be in position. He will also check the condition of engine room, fan flaps, and may try out the open-close mechanism. The inspector will check emergency lights for the lifeboat station. Procedures for launches of lifeboat should be posted. Fire plan is in place together with crew list, stowage plan, and cargo material safety data sheet for the current port. It is a good practice to put security seals for lifeboat entrance hatches and also for diesel generator room and other critical emergency spaces of the ship to prevent from stowaways. Never put padlocks for such places. Always remember, safety has priority under security. He will check test pressure in air cylinders and operation of lifeboat air system. He will ask to start lifeboat engine using one or both batteries.
Yeah.
Then he will ask to steer the wheel hard to port or starboard to see if the rudder is moving. He will check procedures for on-load release system and the handle is in proper reset position. Safety pin is in place. The inspector will check that bottom plug is in position and no water inside. He will test the lifeboat searchlight. Housekeeping and cleanliness of the lifeboat is must. He will check expiry dates of water, first aid kit, food rations and pyrotechnics. Lifeboat release hooks should be in good condition and greased. Release hooks would be also checked by inspector for easy moving and proper position of the pins. The inspector will examine lifeboat embarkation ladder. Rope shouldn't have any visible deteriorations. The steps and the shackles should be in good condition. He will check the overall condition of lifeboat davits, hoisting wire and winch. Wire renewed date and 5 years test date should be stenciled. He will check save all trays from engine room for oily water residues. These areas should be cleaned and maintained in dry condition with plugs properly secured. He will check garbage collection and storage areas for color coding and proper garbage segregation. He will check that mooring winches are on brakes and there are not less than 4 turns on the working drum, but also not more than full air on the working drum. The sea valves under the winches should be cleaned, dry and plugged. He will check the aft emergency towing equipment and instructions for their use. The release mechanism should be operational. Also, he will check the operation of signal light inside the box and condition of messenger rope. He will check the condition of bottles in Acetylene store, its proper storage, instructions and applicable material safety data sheet. There should be no any padlocks on diesel generator room, only security seal if necessary during port stay. The inspector will check the emergency generator room and may try out the system. Ensure proper records of testing is available. Remote fuel valve is clearly marked and operating mechanism is in good order. Paint store is usually used as a sample locker. The samples should be properly stored to avoid accidental dropping during bad weather. All samples should be disposed to show facilities with proper documentation. Material safety data sheet for paint and for cargo bunker samples should be in place. He will check the procedures for launches of life raft. He will check life raft's condition and expiry date of hydrostatic release unit. He will check that scupper plugs are properly in place and its condition. At the break of accommodation, welding pumps on both sides will be tested for readiness. Bonding cables of two welding pumps at upper end main deck should be connected. Discharge hoses from same region to slope tank should be able to be used in a closed cycle without releasing inert gas from slope tanks, which means the connections should have quick couplings. Dump oil spill valve should be operable and in good condition. The date when the deck seal was last inspected will be checked. Should be less than 1 year. The level of the liquid in deck seal on the side glass will be checked. The glass should be transparent. The non-return valve on the main IG line will be checked. Should be in operation condition for open close. The date of cleaning overhauling should be stenciled on the valve. The annual pressure test date should be stenciled on the pipelines. The pipelines should be identified properly by number and naming system, like cargo line number 1, 2, 3, and IG line, bunker line, etc. The inspector will check overall condition of pipelines. The pipeline tracer coupling will be checked for movements and cables for electric continuity should be in place. The pipeline supporting stands and U-bolts will be checked for corrosion and wastage. The inspector will ask to open one or two water ballast tanks to check their structural condition. Normally, he will not go down lower than first platform. He will check the condition of life buoys, attached lines and operation of life, if applicable. He will check the condition of ballast tank, ventilation devices and their mesh screens. He will check the condition of air handling unit and its filters for accommodation ladder. The inspector will check pilot ladder. Ensure that there are no knots or splices are seen. All the steps are not painted, dirty or slippery. Check that the steps without any damage and the shackles and rope are in good condition. He will inspect port and starboard gangways. Check the condition of wire rope, pins and rollers for damage corrosion. All equipment should be greased. Wire renewed date should be stenciled. Also, the maximum angle indicator should be available or marked on deck for reference. Maximum allowable persons on the gangway and safe weight load should be stenciled. He will test few lights attached to the life buoys. All safety fire equipment should be marked with luminescent IMO symbols. The inspector can ask to check the oxygen level in cargo tank with closed type method, and appropriate portable gas detector should be used as a tank scope. If necessary to test lower parts of the tank, you should have a sampling hose long enough. The inspector will ask to check the independent high-level overfill alarm. Light and sound of the alarms should be operational and in good condition. Fire main line isolation belts will be randomly tried out for operation. The size of IG connection flange to water ballast system should be the same as the flange size installed on water ballast tanks. Special portable ventilation hoses should be available on board for inert gas supply to ballast system with the same flange sizes and enough length to connect water ballast tank with IG line. The individual IG branch valves should be secured in open position. The blocking arrangement and the status should be indicated in the cargo control room. Four main line isolation valves will be randomly tried out for proper operation. The manifold drip tray should be clean and dry. The inspector will ask the location of emergency stop buttons for cargo oil pumps. You should be able to demonstrate their location and documents with pre-arrival test. All pressure gauges covers should be removed and the valves should be opened. Manifolds not in use should show zero pressure. Safe weight load should be marked on mooring chocks, bollards, pedestal rollers, etc. Manifold support stand should be marked with safe weight load for cargo hose resting force. All manifolds should be properly identified. Manifolds not in use should be blank with all nuts and bolts in place. The midship crane will be checked in operation for hydraulic leaks and the limit switches will be tried out. PV breaker will be inspected for liquid level. The PV breaker settings for pressure and vacuum should be properly marked on the unit. Also, the last inspected date should be mentioned on this unit. You should be able to demonstrate the inspector how to check liquid level, inert pressure of the PV breaker and outer pressure of inert gas in the system. Use special tables from PV breaker manual to convert liquid level to millimeters water grade pressure. The pressure gauge reading on the PV breaker for the inert gas line should be the same in cargo control room and on the bridge. Mast riser as a part of inert gas system would be inspected. The date of the last cleaning overhauling should be stenciled. Mast riser top cover and mesh screen should be in good condition. Mast riser breather valve will be inspected for operation, if applicable. The pressure vacuum valves will be tested for pressure and vacuum. The chief officer should be able to explain to the inspector what kind of maintenance is carried out on these PV valves. The pressure and vacuum settings should be stenciled on the units. The cargo heating system should be in good condition, and inspector could ask you the date of last heating coil's pressure test and how did you perform the test. Hydraulic boxes for cargo ballast valves should be clean and tidy. All ballast and cargo tank domes safety pins should be available. The shaft should be properly greased. If you are a vetting inspector and like to share with me your experience, please do not hesitate to contact me. The inspector will check the railings for emergency embarkation ladder. It should be in operational condition with safety pins easily moved by hands. The inspector will check mooring equipment such as pedestal rollers are able to move by hands. It is a good practice to stencil mark certificates, numbers of wire ropes and tails for all mooring winches. The date of the last winch brake testing adjusting should be stenciled on the winches, showing winch brake rendering capacity. He will check the brakes are set to rendering point and it is clearly marked. The inspector will check that all mooring winches brakes are fully tight and out of gear. Both anchors should be kept ready for immediate use and anchor lashing should be removed. Nevertheless, the guillotine bar should be engaged to avoid accidental dropping of anchor. He will check the condition of single buoy mooring bow stopper, certificate marking and safe weight load. Safety pins should be easily removed. He will check the condition of chain for emergency towing. Height and condition of the ventilators and their closing devices will be thoroughly checked as this area is mostly the subject of bad weather. It is a good practice to stencil entry procedure to Forecastle Store near the entrance door. The power switch for the ventilation system Forecastle Store should be operable either from outside the Forecastle Store or at the entrance with the light switches. Emergency towing booklet should be available in the Forecastle Store. Portable light for the forward life raft vacation ladder point will be tested. Port and starboard bitter end arrangements for the anchors will be checked inside the Forecastle Store. It should be easily accessible and without any obstacles. A hammer is kept and ready for use in case of emergency. The inspector could check bilge alarm inside the Bosun store, and the officer watch will notify that the alarm is operational in the cargo control room. A thorough examination of the anchor watch system will be made to ensure no leaks or marks of leaks visible on the anchor hose pipe. The inductor system and overboard valve provided forward should be kept in closed position and should be clearly marked not to be opened without chief officer permission. The procedures of how to induct chain lockers and bosun store should be posted. Life jackets lights should be operational. Life jackets and immersion suits should be in good condition with no sign of tears or damage. Light for the forward life raft station will be checked. The inspector will examine forward life raft embarkation ladder. Rope shouldn't have any visible deteriorations. Steps and shackles should be in good condition. I repeat that it should be not less than 4 turns of mooring wire on the winch working drum, but not more than full layer. Visitors' logbook and warning notices should be near the gangway regarding mobiles, naked lights, non-intrinsical equipment which are not allowed on open deck, and also smoking regulations on board. Safety board should be available with first aid kit, fire plan, international shore connection coupling and security level notice. The inspector will check helicopter equipment locker. Fireman's suits should be in good condition and ready for use. He will check the tightness of mask. You will check pressure in cylinder of self-contained breathing apparatus. You will also test the whistle. Oil spill equipment should be in good order and properly stored. The inventory list of such equipment should be available and updated. Oil spill equipment should be deployed near the drip tray together with fire extinguishers and fire hoses. Pressure gauges on the ship's cargo lines should show correct readings, same as in the cargo control room. Home monitors should be pointed towards the manifold shore side. Colleagues, thanks for watching. I wish you safe voyages and calm seas.